Hey everyone, in today's video we're going into how to make highly profitable Facebook ads quickly and easily in 2019 for beginners. Let's go. Hey everyone and welcome back to the video. My name is Ricky Hayes and we're going into how to make highly profitable Facebook ads in 2019 quickly and easily right now. So don't forget though to like, share, subscribe and hit the notification bell. Let's go straight into it. So moving on from last video where we've now made this and I've explained the strategy, how to do it quickly, how to do it easily. Now we need to make the actual ad. So we've told Facebook the who, where, what, why. Now what we're doing is we're setting up what these people are going to see. Okay, and so you're going to have a Facebook page set up. So I've already gone ahead and set up a Facebook page. That'll be in another video where I'll teach you how to do that and optimize that. But in this one, we're going into if you already have a Facebook page. Now, you can also have an Instagram page. It has to be a business Instagram page, and you can connect it into your business manager under the business manager Instagram settings. Okay. But in this case, if you don't have one, that's nothing to be worried about. You can just use selected page. Okay. Now, I wanted to explain there's multiple formats for how you can make ads on Facebook based on many different things. It can be based on, for instance, where you want to place your ad. For instance, you might want to choose a different type of ad that converts better for that placement. If you're doing Instagram, you usually need a different video resolution or image resolution as opposed to Facebook because of how the platforms are both set up. Okay, so it's really important that you understand that, and I'm just going to teach you what each of these are so that you can use them, and I'm going to tell you which one is my preferred and how to go about setting it up. Okay, so there's Carousel. Now, Carousel, as the name suggests, it's basically you can use videos, but it's predominantly images. You will see it a lot with fashion and jewelry related stores, because the image basically says the whole product in itself, okay? So you only need an image to remind people of what the product really is. So that's where a carousel is. And you can see down here, we've got a carousel and Facebook's got some different preview images. And so you can set up, it always comes up with this new stuff, but you can set up manually inputting text. So let's put in this as a test, okay? And we're going to see that straight away that's where the text is. So this text field relates to above the carousel. Now, I always recommend leaving these ticked if you're doing carousel. And you can add multiple more carousel slides if you want as well. In the case for this one, we're just going to use the one slide and we're going to add this product here that I've just brought in. And you can see how now it populates. And the good thing with carousel is it resizes the image automatically, so it has optimal chances of conversion, which is really handy. So you want to set up a headline, and you can see a headline here correlates to headline one. So Stanley Knife, whatever that product is, okay? So we put in Stanley Knife, and that's going to update straight away. And we put in a description. This is our Stanley Knife, all right? And you can see how quick and easy that really is. All right, and then you want to put in every one of a carousel ad, you might have different products or collections or just different pages that you're marketing these different products to. Because you might make a carousel all on the one product with different images. You can make a carousel of different products in the carousel to different landing pages. So it's important that you make sure you get your destination URL correct, which is usually just, you know, the website, the web page of where you want to send these people. Okay, so that's really important to do that. Otherwise, you can potentially miss out on conversions. Ignore your see more URL. Once you have your page connected, it will auto-populate that, okay? As well as your learn more call to action, because we're doing e-commerce, there's a lot of different types of call to actions. We want to do shop now, okay? Because we want people to shop our store. We want them to buy. So we change that, and that's going to change the shop now button for all of the carousel slides, okay? And you can add all of that, okay? So Facebook gives you recommendations on the sizes as well. So you can do all of that, and you can change that. I also recommend leaving these ticked again, and that's how you set up a carousel in a quick and easy fashion. You can have a single image as well. So you can feature a single image, whereas carousel is more aimed at multiple images. A single image is really trying to convey a point in a single image. And single image works best when you have a highly optimized image, okay? It's really important if you are using a singular image that you are using an image that's going to, that is optimized for the dimensions that Facebook recommends. Okay, so Facebook will always recommend different dimensions, and you can look at always the dimensions here, 1080 by 1080 ratio 1:1. Okay, so if you want to use this, it's definitely important that you make sure that you have that because you want the image to look optimal, otherwise it may not achieve the result that you are after. Okay, it's really important. And you can see how, again, you basically have the text, you have the website URL and the headline and the call to action. Okay, we don't use, we don't really use single image all that much. It's e-commerce, digital marketers. We mainly use the one that I was going to, which is single video. Okay, so video for e-commerce works best. The reason that to justify why that is it's dependent on the niche, of course. So as I said, if you're fashion, jewelry, Carousel does really well, for instance. But if you're, let's say, promoting a garden tool or an LED, let's say the LED dog collar, okay, people want to see how it works. And the best way to see how something works is a video. Okay, and so it's really important that you use a video. I have other videos on how to find that in other videos. We're not going to go into that today. But you want to use a video. Okay, and so if you have a video, upload it there. Again, you've got that it can be up to 15 seconds. It gives you the dimensions. And Facebook and Instagram as well do have different dimensions. So keep that in mind. All right. So now that we know how to do that, let's say we have uploaded a video, and you can also use templates. If you only have images, I want to add as well, you can use templates. So if we only have a template, you could just use, if you only had images, you can use one of these templates to make it into a video, which is actually quite good if you have a number of good images and you want to make it into a video quickly and easily. Facebook gives us that option. Okay, so you want to add text again. Now, I have other videos on how to set up text to, that's a high converting text for Facebook ads. Okay, so I suggest going to watch them. Plenty of links in the description as well as in my channel. The website URL, you always want to send them to your specific product page, okay, because it gives you the highest chances of conversion. So if you're doing the LED dog collar on dogs.com, send them to your LED dog collar page on your dog's website, okay? And your headline, again, you want to put in a headline, and I have a video on that. So you can see how they're all very similar, just, you know, it's mainly the actual creative, which is the creative being the image or video predominantly in a different fashion. But the text, website field, headlines, they're all pretty much the same. And it's always important that you just use the shop now call to action button, okay? So that's important, and you go confirm at the end. Now, just lastly, I wanted to explain, you can create a slideshow as well. So you can create a slideshow using images or videos. For e-commerce, we don't really need that all that much. You can create a slideshow, and you can also create collection ads. All of these work best for fashion, jewelry-related items for the most part, and those are in other videos. So we don't really need to do anything there. I would always recommend using video and just uploading a video that you have gotten for marketing your product, and then following setting up these text fields. Okay, so it's always really important you set up the text field. Take the time to do it properly, because it really does make a difference to if you get a sale or if you don't get a sale. And if you do want to get sales, I highly recommend that you take that action. So if we so once you have done all of this, let's say hypothetically you have completed this whole process, we have now gone ahead and we've got an ad account. So I will be making another video on ad accounts and how they work, how to manage them, and why they're so important for us. But we have an ad account because you need an ad account in order to be able to market. That's how Facebook have it set up. We now have the who, where, what, why people. And now we know how to make ads, and we know how to make them quickly and easily. And then we just go confirm. And once you go confirm, you can go review. So you can actually see an overview of the ad. And Facebook's actually going to tell you if there's any problems in the review. So it will tell you if there's anything that you should be fixing. And usually that comes down to if you've missed a field, if you've missed a field, if you haven't uploaded the image, if Facebook, admittedly, I'll be honest, does have a number of bugs where you do something and then it reverts it back. So that's just something to be mindful of, but it's important to have a quick look at these reviews. And you can click the fix errors to have a look at that. But for the most part, once you have it set up and you get the hang of it, then you just go confirm. And once you go confirm, Facebook is going to go through a review status. Okay, and that review status is they have technology in place to audit your ads, as well as they have dedicated teams in place to manually review your ads to make sure it adheres to their policies. Of course, various things that are illicit material, or gambling, things like that, go heavily against their terms of service. So it's very important that Facebook mandate that. We're not doing any of that, of course. There's nothing to worry about, but that's important to keep in mind. Okay, it's very important to keep in mind, so that you're not, your account, or you don't have any troubles with Facebook. Okay, hey everyone, hope you enjoyed today's video on how to set up highly profitable Facebook ads quickly and easily in 2019. Okay, guys, now don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my videos so that you get weekly value delivered straight to you. Okay, guys, there's a lot of value, and I'll be giving a lot more of that in this ongoing tutorial on how to set up Facebook ads and so much more. I highly recommend that you check out all my other videos as well. There is so much value there for you to go from where you are in your journey through to an expert and start absolutely crushing it in 2019. Okay, guys, thank you so much for your time. Have a lovely day. Take care.